Okay guys, in this next video, you're gonna see, it's the first lesson that I'm doing with this couple. It's an 18-month-old female German Shepherd. Really struggles when she's away from home. The owners have done a great job with her obedience. I've seen videos of them working with her at home. Her obedience is very good at home, and she has really good ball drive until she leaves the house. She becomes very dog reactive, very people reactive, and she really just shuts down. She's very uncomfortable whenever she's away from home. She just don't have the confidence. So you'll see in this first video, I actually filmed the whole thing. I'm not gonna post the whole thing because it was about an hour and a half long. And there were a lot of struggles. We struggled really hard. It was mentally draining for the owner and the dog. Very mentally draining, but we busted our butts to get this dog to feel good about herself before she left. And more importantly, to get the owner to feel good about herself before she left. And she did a great job. She really did. And I pushed her really hard to get out of her comfort zone. But obedience doesn't matter if the dog shut down in the head, you know, if the dog struggles. And so we worked really, really hard, you know, really sloppy stuff. It's not pretty. I don't edit this stuff. I just show what we did. And it's fairly long, so you could skip through it if you want, but the whole video was shown. I've shown it this long. I showed what we did for, I don't know, 40 minutes or so. I cut out many clips just so maybe you guys would watch it, is for the last 42 seconds. That's what mattered. We got the dog in a place in her head where we needed her to be. Now, the next time we meet, we can actually start training. So I hope you enjoy.
Where we're at from the start.
Absolutely.
All right. New client. How you doing, buddy?
You're being a good girl. Kelly, sit.
So what'd you give her a treat there for?
She said. She wasn't barking at you.
Okay. All right. Go ahead. Explain. Sorry. So don't let her pull. No. Don't let her pull herself to me. Okay. So this is why I'm filming. So we'll you'll see a difference later on. So we could address, and that's good. I like to see where we're at right from the beginning. So we could address a few things, and then we'll be
like,
fine.
I don't think she would bite a person. A dog, on the other hand.
I just don't know.
Yeah. You can go ahead and drop the lead. Drop the lead. Yet. Don't get nervous about it. Just let it go. Let her be. That was all. Yeah. You guys just sit down if you want. Relax. So as much ball drive as she has, like you guys say, you see, she's just so uncomfortable being here with all the smells right. Without even bringing the dogs out.
Right.
Okay. So that takes over what's more important right now.
Sure.
Okay. So let's just give her a minute.
Yeah, I'm kind of
it's normal. You can have a dog, whatever, you know, that's just a superstar at home, but the second you bring him to a new place with all the distractions.
Yeah, I mean, at home, she is more play-driven than she is anything.
Yeah. Now you see how uncomfortable she is. So as much ball drive and clay drive she has at home, here, she can't be comfortable in her own skin.
Right.
So those things I talked to you about up front that you're doing, the way you're interacting with her, the coddling, the petting, all of the little, the talking, encouraging her that everything's
right.
Okay, it hurts them big time, okay? But we could change that. It just takes a little time. So you probably saw today the work on come, sit, down, place, all that stuff, but that stuff's useless. And I saw your video. So you do a good job with that, but that stuff is useless if we can't fix the head, you know, and make her feel a little better about herself. All she wants to do is escape. I'm just not gonna let her. So that aggression that you see from her towards people that made you nervous that we talked about, that's just fear. That's just fear. If I act like this, those people are gonna go away. Or if I act like this, Mom's gonna pull me away.
Right.
You know what I mean? And that's never a good thing. Because they learn how to win. They learn how to get what they want. Who plays with her at home normally? Come on out here and grab the ball. Throw it right here for her a little bit. So a different dog, right?
Yeah. Not normal at all.
So that's where we start. That's what you gotta say. Okay, we have to make her feel a lot more confident. Okay. So she won't take the ball from you. That shows you just how uncomfortable she really is. That's okay. That's all right. That gives us plenty to work on. What's that?
From your live the other day.
Oh, yeah.
I
get slammed pretty good. I definitely do. Pick up her leash and bring her over here. See if she'll take food from you.
Take food from you?
Mm-hmm. Okay, so no interest in it. Can we see the leash?
Oh, there we go. But we took it that time.
Sit down, relax. She's gonna want to get to you guys. Now you try to work with her. See, the first thing she did was wrap up her hand real tight, got nervous, and now she's falling nervous. Now work her like you would at home to the things she does. Alright, now put her up on top of the place board there. So come on over here. So the first thing you did when you took her is you did this. You are ready, okay? There's nothing but tension. So right at that moment, it's all stuck. There's a lot of tension there. And then you asked her to sit 5, 7, 8 times, and she never did it. And she's in front of you looking away. So there's no interaction there. There's no respect there at all. And then when you get to the crate top, you're up here, okay? So there's no leverage. There's no guidance from the leader. You're just hoping she goes through, and if she decides not to, there's nothing you can do. But if you set her up right here, hey, and you take her right here, there's no tension whatsoever, right? But we teach to help them win. But you see, I'm also very loose on the leash, okay? So there's no tension. I just guide her where I want, and she goes. Now, when she doesn't sit, I want to make her sit, okay? And we'll go from there.
Okay.
All right? Go ahead. Put your arm down. Relax. Come on over here. Now make like you're coming to talk to me and have her sit next to you.
Placey, sit. Sit. Up.
If you tell her to do something, have her do something. So instead of fighting her through it there, if she lays down, just move up a little forward and reset her, okay? And I'm not pushing down, I'm pushing in. If you push down, she's going to fight it, okay? Just in, nice and easy, okay? Go ahead. Put your arm down, relax. Put her back on the crate top. So see where your arm is there?
Yep.
Like you're struggling. Now bring her back off, and I want you to relax with her at your healing left, right? So bring her back to where you want her. Now look where your arm is again. Bring her back here. I want you to start in the right position, okay? And just relax. Don't beat yourself up. There's no getting this wrong. There's no right or wrong.
Okay.
I'm gonna allow you to make mistakes and we'll go through them there. So pull her away from there. So the first thing that we have to utilize with her is when she's on leash with you and she's next to us, she's not allowed to move away, okay? She's not allowed to leave our space. We asked her to be in this space, this is where she needs to be.
Right.
So the second you take the leash, the nose goes down and she goes, okay? That's what we want. She can do that, she can sit there, she can stand there, but she is not allowed to leave and be disrespectful and just blow you up and go where she wants, okay? So pull her back over there, we're gonna start over a little bit, right there. So bring her next to you, see where she goes right away. So you're fixing yourself to her. So the dog always accommodates us, okay? We don't accommodate the dog, okay? And then you're gonna go easy, very easy. See, there's no tension. So as soon as you relax, but first you take control, like, no, you don't leave my side anymore.
Right.
You're gonna see a little bit of a difference, okay? Put your arm down and relax. See how much tension there is?
Right.
Just relax. Take one step forward. Stop right there. Stop looking at her. See how you're always doing this? She should be looking for you. So as long as you're always looking to the dog, they have no reason to look for you. Now I want you to just go. Don't say nothing, just go. Good, much better. Put your arm down. Do it again. That's okay, that was much better. But you see where you go here right away? See how hard you're grabbing the leash?
Right.
Barely hold it. Okay? Put her back on that side. And I'm leaving the collar you came on purpose, okay? I want to do it with that, you know, she's going to struggle with it. Look where your arm is.
Yeah.
Go back. Don't let it go there. If you have to go here, I want you giving her a correction first, okay? Give her a correction. Do whatever you got to do. But make it quick. Make it sharp. That's it, like that. Now relax. Loosen up your grip. Good. Just relax. Now, when you go, if you put yourself right along the right side, you don't give her room to go between you and the crate. She can't fail, okay? But I just want you to stay there in case she tries to move away. Don't let her. Atta girl. Good. Get her head off the ground. Just correct it. Okay, don't pull. She's going to just do the opposite and pull against you. Now just go and put her up there. Relax. Now you relax. Okay. Are you still looking for it?
Yeah.
Now, let me tell you again. Better?
Yeah.
A little better. But I want you to relax. You're really, really, you're anxious right now. So we can't expect her not to be. Okay? The head goes down, you fix it. Alright? I tell you, walk over there to see if she follows you, and I just won't let her. That just lets her know that's not what I want.
Right.
So that's with a loose, flat collar. Is that going to hurt her? No. But you have to stop the intention of her going over there.
Okay.
Move a little bit more. You want her following. Okay? A little bit more. You want her following. But I'm not going to look for her. Okay? No tension. Right? No stress. Go ahead. Stop looking at her. See how you're always worried about what she's thinking, what she's doing?
Right.
Just relax. Just relax. Take one step forward. Look at
you.
Look what you're doing. See how tight you are? Gotta relax. It should feel like she's not with you. If she goes to remove herself, quick. Do it quick before she gets out far.
Right.
Okay? So the first thing we have to do before we can move forward everything is just get the dog to respect your space. That's it. Do exactly opposite of what she's used to doing, right? So usually you get the leash, boom, she goes. Take one step forward, relax. That's better. She goes to go forward, quick pop across the front of you. Not pulling her back because she's just going to pull into it. Take another step forward. One more. That a girl. Good. Good job. Now, go up there, but remain relaxed. All right? Now relax. Now we want her up there, so don't let her off. Now you see what you're doing? You're holding her on. Okay? She goes to get off, just let her know. It's not what I want. Yeah. So instead, you're pulling.
Right.
She's pulling.
Okay?
So we want this loose all the time. If she's doing something where we have to stick her, it's going to be quick. Okay? She's going to be here. Quick. Quick. Take her, do it again. Now right there, your arm goes right there and you're fighting her the whole time. Correct her. Instantly.
Okay.
Instantly. Do not let her cross. As soon as she goes too far out, now you have no leverage.
Right.
Okay, so the second you start walking, before she even barely thinks of cutting you off and going over there, give her a quick pop. Okay? Now I want you in all one smooth motion with no tension, put her up there. Much better. Good. Good job. Good job. Now you can give her a little pat if you want. Okay? And that's it. Now take her off and go back over there again. Put your arm down. Now right there. Now, if you have to, she's too far ahead already. So you have to do that. Throw your leg in front of her if you have to. She is not to cross out in front of you, okay? You have to let her know. That's it. You don't go that way anymore, okay? That was much better. Very nice job. If I see the arm, go back to where you are. Turn around. You're facing that way. Okay? Stop doing all that. Use the leverage of the leash. But she's facing the wrong way. So fix her. Put her how you want her. Move up a little bit. Take her with you. Just go now. Do it again. Now she's not to come off of there either. Now, take the end of the leash. Take the end of the leash. Uh-huh. Okay? I want you to move around. She's going to get off. Don't let her. What I want you to do is when you start moving, the second she goes to move, I want you to interrupt it with whatever you use and some facial pressure. I want her paying attention to your body language. She's not going to come off of there. If she does, you put her back quickly, okay? Okay? Put your arm down. Relax.
No.
See? Right here you went, right?
Right.
So let me tell you. I knew you were going to do that. I wanted you to do what you normally do. Okay. So now, if we want her to stay up there, she don't know how to stay up there. She doesn't even know how to get up on there, right? So if we want her to stay, she's going to get off. She's going to. Just move into her. Let her know that's where we want her. And now, we'll help her fail a little bit. Okay? We want her learning to stay up there. Free dog. Good girl. Come on. Atta girl. Come on, Khaleesi. All right, Khaleesi. And notice, we don't give it, we're not saying what to do yet, right? Come on, girl. Now we're making her move a little bit. There's no command or nothing. She don't know this.
Right.
She just knows what we're having her do. Good. Good. All right, I want her on this side. See where Khaleesi is with me? Going in front of me, right?
Right.
I'm coming. Good. There's no tension there. I'm not struggling like this. No tension. Good. Now, when she didn't go and she's looking over there, all in this straight line, just barely enough for her to know which direction we want her to go, okay? Now we want her to hang out there for a while. Okay. Go stand over there, please. You'll want to go with me. Okay. This is as basic as it gets.
Right.
But we have to develop some kind of communication there. As you know, you can't do that stuff anymore, you know? We need you kind of tuning in with us here.
Right.
But we can't allow this to fight each other. We use this to help her, to guide her. That's it. Come here, Khaleesi. That a girl. Come here. Good. Let's go. Now she thought about it. She thought about going, she caught herself. And that's good. Little tiny bit.
Right.
Okay. Come on over here and take her. Just take her and go. And walk all around with her. Don't say nothing. Now you put her on the other side. Now come. Put her where she belongs. And just go. Get her nose off the ground. Look. Not like this. Go. Don't let her stop. Correct that. Walk up this way again. Okay, you're dragging. Get her head off this bed and go. She goes, just pop, pop, pop. But you can't keep dragging.
Right.
Okay, you're fighting. It's too much. Okay, you're going to walk around. Put your arm down. Don't pull. Pop. Atta girl. Good job. Much better. There you go. Put your arm down. You're dragging. Gotta be a little more meaningful. The first one was very good. She stops and she literally starts paying attention. But you see what you're going back to doing? You're letting her put that head down. Right. We don't want the head going down. So you have to have leverage on this here. So if the head goes down, quick. There has to be a little pop in there, okay? There has to be. Let's go, please. Come on, girl. Let's go. Get her moving. Make her work. But that means you have to move with her. Come on, girl. Get up here. Let's go. Up here. Atta girl. Good job. Good job, mama. You guys take her? It sucks, right? It's hard.
Come on.
And what did you do right away?
On
you put her on the wrong side immediately. So you have to set some boundaries and be right. Consistent here with her. Now, when I tell you to, okay, you're gonna walk again that way. But you see the difference in how she respects me, she's never met? She gives me a little more than she gives you, right? Now, stop right there. When I tell you to, when you're walking that way, when I say now, I want you to take your right leg and I want you to swing it into her and turn right around the opposite direction. Don't hesitate, do it quickly, okay? Go ahead. Now. No. You're so scared of bumping her. Walk up that way. When I say now, take your right leg and swing it in there.
Okay.
Relax. Now. Atta girl. Good. Better. Good job. Go that way. Now this time do it a little harder. Now. No. You never touched her with your leg. I want to see you hit the right leg. Okay? Do it now. Right now. Look, correct. We're not trying to guide her, okay? If she's right here, okay? All right, take it. Let her not want to touch it, okay? She's right here, okay? Let her not want to touch it, okay? I just want her to stop crossing out in front of you. That way. Put your arm down. Now? No. You're using your left leg because you're so scared of hurting her. Okay? Do not touch her with your left leg. I want you to take that right leg and hit her in the chest.
Go ahead. You go get it. Keep going. Don't give up on her. That a girl. There you go. Beautiful. Now praise her big time. Nice job. Play with her again. There you go. Excellent. That is fantastic. Now, do you see why we did what we did? Outstanding. Have a good time with her. Have a blast with her. Tease her, play with her. How's that feel?
Good.